All right, so today we'd like to cover the first of four different accepted methods for calibration of your scale. And this is the most accurate method, and it's the one that we're always going to recommend that you consider first. And that is to use standardized test weight for calibration of your scale. Now it's important that you take a moment to reference Handbook 44 based on the capacity of your scale to determine the accepted minimum recommended amount for calibration. In this particular case, I have a 50-pound scale base here, and Handbook 44 would recommend that I use a full 50 pounds to calibrate the scale. And so the procedure, of course, you'll want to reference your manual for the particular indicator that you have for the steps on how to get through the menu to perform the calibration. But the basic steps are pretty much going to be the same. We're going to start with a zero calibration, so I'm going to hop into the menu here quick. And I'm going to come over to calibration, and this first step that I see is a W0. So at this point, I want to make sure that there is zero weight on the scale. And once I've made sure that that's taken care of, I'm going to go ahead and execute that. Now that the zero calibration is complete and it lets me know with the OK message here on this particular model, the 680, I'm going to go ahead and accept that value. And I'm going to go over to my WVal. That's for weight value. So I have to tell the indicator how much weight I'm going to put on the scale. Otherwise, it's not going to know. So I'm going to come down into here and verify that this says 50 pounds. That's what I'm going to use to calibrate with. So once I have that in place, I'm going to accept that. And now I'm at my WSpan. So I'm going to go ahead and make sure that I put my 50 pounds on the scale. Give that a moment to settle, and then we'll go ahead and execute the span. And when it's all done and gives me that message, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to exit, and we see that we have a calibrated scale.